Glad to have Bishop with us. Can we give God praise for the man of God? I've got to ride to church with my man this morning. We got to ride together in the same vehicle, and it was a blessing. And it's good, always good to be in on Sunday morning with Don in church. So we thank God for our bishop. Welcome the servant of God as he comes.
God bless you. Why don't you greet somebody around you or beside you and just give them a big smile and just say, it's good to see you in the house of the Lord. Now, whether you want a fist bump or... Amen. I want you to remain standing with us. It's so good to be here today, to see everybody. You know, I do a tremendous amount of video, and I do a tremendous amount of media. So when I get an opportunity to be among people, I truly, truly enjoy it. I really do. But we love you. Pastors Ron and Katie are getting some well-deserved time off, and also some well-deserved time to themselves and just to enjoy, you know, that, because they are bivocational. They're not only pastors, but they also work in education. So a well-needed time for them, and I'm just honored to be here today to fill in that gap and make up that hedge. But I do have something that God has put upon my heart that I think will just flow with what the Lord has been saying here today. Are you glad to be in the house of the Lord? Amen. Let's praise Him for it. I want you to read a scripture with me, and we're going to read the one scripture, and then after that, I'm going to be talking today about God wants to use you in your gifts and abilities through serving. And I know the first thing somebody thinks a lot of times, well, is that just in the church? Well, no, it could be in the community. It could be in the whole area, the whole region. You know, my ministry for probably now over 10 years has been outside the building here, outside the church. And, you know, we've just seen hundreds and hundreds of lives touch, and even I could say thousands, and we're so thankful for what the Lord has done. But let's read this together if we can, as we stand for the reading of God's Word. We want to honor Him today. God wants to use you and your giftings and abilities through serving. This is a quote that I've had for many, many years. I did not serve to be saved, but I'm saved to serve. Before we read the scripture, can you repeat that after me? I did not serve to be saved, but I am saved to serve. Can we read it again or say it again? I did not serve to be saved, but I'm saved to serve. This is very important to understand. Just one scripture, and then I'll go back into them. You don't have to stand the whole time. Romans chapter 12, verse 6. Having then gifts... Everybody say, having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to me. Let's bow our heads. Father, we're so grateful and thankful for this day. We thank you for the privilege we have to be in the house of the Lord. We thank you for the strength that we have to be here. Just waking us up this morning, protecting us on the roads as we traveled. You've been so good to us time after time after time, and we thank you. As I stand here today to share your word, pray that you'll remind me, God, that I'll have to give an account of everything that I preach and minister. But remind everyone here, they'll have to give an account of what they do and how they apply it. Help us all to not only be hearers, but doers of your word. And help us not only simply, Lord, hear the word, but help us with daily application. We just praise you today. Let your precious spirit just cover this place. Almighty God, embrace us today. Lord, we thank you so much. We invite you into this house today. We praise you in the name above every name, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you for standing for the reading of God's Word. I want to go back again and read this first part of this scripture and then come back to some other parts of it. Having then gifts differing. Now, everybody here, God gave you a certain amount of gifts and ability when you was born into this earth. Now, what you do along the way, you enhance them. You develop them even further. But everybody here is gifted, but everybody's gifted in a different way. The worst thing that you ever did in your entire life is compare yourself with somebody else. That's crazy. Don't do it. I'm telling you, you'll never get nothing from that. The Bible says if we compare ourselves among ourselves, we are not wise. So we don't want to be comparing ourselves among ourselves. Look around for just a minute and see if you see another you. Do you see another you anywhere? No, I don't see another you anywhere. You're unique. I've said this for years and years. I'm a one of a kind, God designed, right from his mind. So every one of us are different, even though we may have some of the same skill sets. We really are different in what God gives us. Now, what we need to understand is that God created us to be creative. Did you know that? I want to read a scripture from you in the Old Testament out of Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, 27. Just a part of that that says, God created man in his image and after his likeness. So every one of us are created, talk to me, in his image, right? And after his, is that the word of God? So if I'm created in his image and after his likeness, that means, was God a created God? Well, that means he's also put inside of us creative abilities. Now, you probably think for just a moment, oh, not me, I can't create nothing. Listen, you either create bad or you create good. You create wonderful things or you create awful things. I've seen some folks raise some hell and create some bad things. Anybody else? Y'all didn't catch that, did you? I tried to catch you there for a minute, but you didn't catch it. I'm glad you didn't. But every one of us, God has given us ability to create and to come up with things. He's given us giftings and abilities. But the sad thing that I look at sometime when I look at people's lives, they do nothing with what God has given them. Listen, I want to do everything I can with what God's given me. I know God's gifted me and given me abilities and talents. I know that without any doubt whatsoever. At the age of 14, I picked up a guitar and started banging on it. Couldn't play a lick then, but I had of that, and then suddenly it began to come to me. There's many other things. I've done 25 years of television, and you know what? I didn't think I had a gift of television. I never went to school for it, never went to college for it. But lo and behold, I done 25 years of television. I've had people ask me, how long did you go to school to learn to do that? I said, I never did. I just seen somebody do it, and I said, I think I can do that. And now, is college good? Absolutely. Is school good? Absolutely. Is training and teaching good? Absolutely. But every one of us has those unique, special gifts that God has put in our lives. So we want to use them in a positive, godly, and righteous way. Now, everybody don't have the same gifts. Now, some of you may think you have the gift to sing, but you know, proof is in the pudding. I got to tell you a story about my son and my daughter. Years ago, when he was teaching at UNC Greensboro, Joanna was going to nursing school there. I would go down periodically and visit him. So I went down one Sunday to my cousin's church, who pastored at that time in Greensboro. And we went in, and you know, they're traditional Presbyterian church. They have the song books, and they sing the hymns. I love the hymns, because a hymn is any truth lifted out of Scripture. So I love the hymns. We was in there, and I was here, and Joanna was on one side, and Joshua was on the other side. So suddenly, I forgot what it is, Blessed Assurance or Amazing Grace. I forgot which one it was. Now, Joanna has a really good voice. She can really sing real good. And she's singing, and I'm singing. I work at singing. I don't think I've got a great voice for it, but I do work at singing. So I'm singing, she's singing. Then all of a sudden, we hear this voice coming out of nowhere, this Amazing Grace. So Joanna takes and she looks around me at her brother. And she's He was enjoying himself. Now the person in front of him wasn't, because the person in front of him went. Now he's got better. He has got better at it. I will tell you that. But that's not his gifting. His gifting is in academics, and he is an outstanding, great teacher. He is a genius in academics. He's phenomenal on teaching that. So that's not his gifting. So he found out that he couldn't make it through singing, that his gifting was in academics. So sometimes you have to learn your strengths. You have to learn where God can use you at. Can I get an amen? And I'm not just talking in church now, but I'm talking even in career. I've seen people just determined to go in a certain career, and they was absolutely, positively no good at it. And then they'd wonder, they'd say at that time, pastor or bishop, they'd say, you know, I can't understand. I just am not any good at this. I said, I knew the answer. I said, maybe you need to try something else. And they did, and they was good at it. So sometimes what we think and what we really need to hear, and we need to really listen to something called constructive criticism. Amen. Talk to me now. Now, some of you in here have been in corporate environments and business worlds for many years, and you know as well as I do that you can look at somebody and be around them for a while and understand whether they're going to make it or not make it, or whether maybe they need to try to do something else. That's like everybody that goes to college, and I do appreciate Sister April back here, what she does at CVCC, because she helps guide young men and women into their career. And she's a blessing at that. But not everybody needs to go, am I right, April, in an academic path. Not everybody does. Some people need to go into a trade path. Some people need to become electricians. Some people need to become plumbers. I mean, they make great money. We heard a gentleman tell us Friday about his son who is a lineman. He's a lineman. He went to Caldwell and got an associate's degree or certificate or something in becoming a lineman, and makes over $100,000 a year. 1 week brought home $2,400. Now, everybody don't scramble to become linemen, because that may not be your calling. It is not mine. I'm not getting up on no pole and holding all this juice in my hand. There's no way I'm going to do it. But you understand what I'm talking about today? As I heard somebody say, do you catch my drift? All right. Let's keep going on this thing. In Romans chapter 12, he said, having been gifted, differing according to the grace that's given to us. He's talking more of a theological aspect here. Whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of our faith. There is a time and an ability. There's a proportion that we do. If somebody's better than you, respect that. You know, let them go ahead of you. It's all right. Your time will come. Or ministry. 7, let us wait on ministry. Or they that teaching on teaching, or they that teach on teaching, or they that exhort on exhortation. They that give, let them do it with simplicity. They that rule, let them do it with diligence. They that show mercy, with cheerfulness. I like what it says in 1 Corinthians 12:4. Now there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are differences of administrations, but the same Lord. There are diversities of operations, but is the same God which works all in all. This is 1 Corinthians 12:4-7. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every person to profit withal. And then 1 Corinthians 12:31 says, covet earnestly the best gifts. What I'm doing now, I feel, is my best gift that God has put in my life, what I'm doing right now to you. I'm a preacher teacher. I take things that are hard and try to make them simple. Is that good? Now, my son's an academic. He takes things that are simple and tries to make them hard. Me and him have discussion on this. But I'm a communicator. I want to take things that are hard and make them simple. Every one of us in here, gifted, abilities, talents. It's amazing. If we started bringing you up here and we started interviewing you, what you could tell me and what you could share to me about all that you can do in your life. Some people here are good cooks. I know that. Some people are good bakers. I know that. See, the thing about it is God gives every one of us special unusual talents and gifts and abilities. But what we want to do, read it with me up here. God wants to use you, what? Your gifts and abilities through serving. Let's say it again. God wants to use your gifts and abilities through serving. This is very important. I tell people this. I did not serve to get saved, but once I was saved, I'm saved to serve. I want to say, Lord, here am I. You know a prayer we pray every day. God, where are we needed? Where are we wanted? Where do you want to use us at? And you know, it's amazing how God opens those doors, how God puts people in our path or puts us in their path, and we minister to those people. Sometimes it's a large crowd. I had the privilege on Friday to speak at the police officers' memorial service up at Catawba Memorial Park at the monument there for police officers. It was my honor to do that. Tremendous turnout took place on Friday from all our departments. I think every one of them in Catawba County came. So it was an honor to do that. But the thing about it was, I didn't ask that. It just happened. So there are many times, if you just make yourself available to God, if we ain't careful, we're trying to hide from God when God wants to use you, because what do? You say within yourself, oh, not me. You don't want me to pull you out of that seat, do you? Oh, not me. Do you realize how many great giftings and talents and abilities that God has placed in your life? I see it. I don't know you. Have we met? What's your name? Edith? Well, let me get a handshake. God bless you, Edith. Can I tell you something? I see it all in you. See, God gives me the gift to reveal and to see things. And I see it all in your life. I see the gifts and the talents and the abilities. And can I go just a step further? I also see the hurts and the things that have just devastated you at times and have grieved you at times. And sometimes it's just, you say, oh God, how much more can I take? But I want to tell you something. God's going to turn some things for you. Father, I just thank you today for this lady. I thank you for your presence. God, I see great giftings and abilities and all these talents that stored up in her. But Lord, I also see the hurts and the wounds and the emotional trauma and the things that she's went through. Now today it's a new day. It's a brand new time for this lady's life. Lord, it's going to start anew and start afresh. I pray for her in the name of Jesus today. Minister powerfully, Lord, into her life. Lord, even today when she leaves this place, let her leave here with a new determination. God's going to use me in a mighty way. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We cover this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. You watch it. It's a new day for you. God's going to build a new confidence there in you. I see it and I believe it. I really do. Every one of you, gifted, talented, great abilities is within you. Listen, don't let your moment get by you, because time goes so quick and goes so fast. While you got breath in your body, let God use you. While you're up and you're walking and you're doing, let God use you. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting on? Somebody said, I'm waiting on somebody to tell me. Well, I'm telling you. How much more? Exactly. I'm telling it. Oh, my. I've been there before. I've been there before. And I said, and I think when somebody would say, well, I remember when I was really young, and I was first starting in ministry, and I remember the pastor said, I've got a small Sunday school class. I really need somebody to teach it. He knew he wanted to get, but at the same time, I'm thinking, oh, not me, and I'm trying to hide. Sometimes, it's hard to hide from God. You can run, but you might as well give up. Because, listen, he is so big, he's already got there before you get there. He's so wide you can't get around him. He's so deep you can't go underneath of him. He's so high you can't go over top of him. Where are you going? Nowhere. So yield yourself. Oh, that's all you got to do is say, Lord, here am I. And if you want to ask me where my ministry started, it started at Friendship Baptist Church. back in 1973 in that little Sunday school class teaching just a few little children. And also, I think my baby brother was in there who I have to run after, and I almost wanted to kill him, but I had to stay spiritual. I give God all glory, praise, and honor. Last week, 50 years of preaching, 50 years in ministry. I am so thankful. I am so thankful. God wants to use you, 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 every single one of you. He wants to use you in several different areas. I believe with all my heart, there's three things we need to give God. We need to give God part of our time, we need to give God part of our talent, and part of our treasure, meaning our finance. And when you do that, you find a new purpose in life. And somebody said, well, if I give God that, I'm going to miss out on all the other stuff. No, you won't. It's amazing how your time will even be better. Give God part of your time. Give God part of your talent. Give God part of your treasure. Someone says, all I can do is bake a cake. Oh, my God. Sister Dorothy, Sister Kimberly, is Sister Willie here? Sister Willie back there. How many people have y'all ministered to with your food? Thousands, right? Thousands. Thousands. I know your Italian cream cakes ministered to me. It's just been wonderful. Do you understand what I'm saying? That's how God used these ladies, so profound and powerful, where the presence of God is so real. How many has been to the Robinson, I started to say Robinson restaurant, but the Robinson house and ate? Raise your hand high if you've been there and ate. Wow, look at there. And I know some others are saying, where is it at? Where is it at? I want to get there. Is it open today? I've never seen them turn anybody down. They always have a heart to serve. And it's so many that's in here that's like that. But we want to do that. We want to look at our lives and realize God wants to use your gifts and ability through serving. I've got something else I want to mention to you that's very powerful. I don't know how long Pastor Ron normally keeps you. I promise to let you out of here 12 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. Is that all right? I won't go past that. I won't go past that. I like what 1 Timothy 4:14 said. Neglect not the gift that's in you, which was given you by prophecy and with the laying on of hands of presbytery. Now, what presbytery is, it's a group of seasoned ministry that lay hands on you. I really believe that there's impartation. I never forget, I was in Tulsa, Oklahoma. This was back in the 80s. Anybody remember Oral Roberts? I never forget when Oral Roberts laid his hand on me and prayed over me and imparted into my life. I never will forget when Apostle Joseph Crandall laid his hands on me back in the 70s and prayed for me and imparted into my life. I've had some great men and women that have prayed for me and imparted into my life. And I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, it makes a difference. But what did he talk about? He said, don't neglect those gifts. How many gifts it might be in you that you're neglected? Wake up. Arise. Be what God wants you to be. You never know. Sometimes there's a hidden great voice that might be in this house. We do serve the community and serve on our jobs and things of this nature. But we also serve in the house of God. It's always been a joy for me to serve in the house. Did you, Pastor Helen? I watch my wife time after time after time. She loves this house. She loves everybody here. She is such a servant. I see her go beyond her own strength sometimes. Yesterday's supposed to have been a day off for her, but know what she's doing. She's going to Sam's and she's getting supplies and she's bringing them back down here. Why? Because she loves God. She loves this house. She loves her people, the people here. It's just, that's the way it is. But when I see so many that I know that's here today that have that same heart, but every one of us need to have that same heart to where we say, I don't want to neglect the gift that's in me. And if you're not sure, go to Pastor Ron, go to Pastor Katie and say, where can I serve at? You say, well, I may start an ushering, or I may start here, or I may start there. Well, that's good. That may not be your gift, but you'll never know till what? Till you try it, exactly. And I just appreciate the ushers that are here. I mean, this morning, there they are, greeting you, welcoming you. I mean, I don't know what time they got here, but what a blessing that is. What a blessing that is they do that. Let's look what else it says here. Now, we are going to pray for you today, and I'm going to lay hands on you today. And Pastor Helen's going to lay hands on you, and Pastor John is going to lay hands on you. We can get the elders to come up, and we're going to do it one by one here in just a moment or two. And I'm going to ask God to stamp the gift in you. There's something hiding in there that God wants to use. Y'all hear me today? I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. I said, there's something. Oh, I got it then. Thank you, God. They call it a hook. I just got the hook. There's something that's in you that's hiding that God wants revealed out of you. Oh, yes, He does. Oh, yes, He does. Oh, yes, He does. There's something that God wants to reveal that's hidden in your life. And we're going to do that today by the laying on of hands in just a little bit. I love this. James 1:17. It said, I'll be through in just a moment. But listen, James 1:17. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above. It comes down from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Now, there are two things he mentions here. He says every good gift. And that's the natural gifts that he brings us and the natural gifts that he brings into our life. In fact, that word good translated means best is what it means. He says every good, but notice what he said. What? The next one. James 1:17. Every good gift and what? Every perfect, which means mature, is from above. Now, the first thing is the natural things all around us that God brings us. Has God brought you some good gifts? Has He been good to you? He's done that for every one of us. But then He says, and every what? Perfect gift. Young man, what's your name? What is it? Jeremiah, you know what a perfect gift is? Is you sitting right here. It's people in our lives. And whether you know it or not, I'm in your life now. Good, bad, or ugly, man, I'm in your life. How about that, Jeremiah? This sounds good to you? You're a good man. You're a good man. But you know what the good gifts are? It's people around us that God gives us. Those are the good gifts. Those are the perfect gifts. Listen, if you just come in this church or been coming here for a small amount of time, we want to know you. I'm not just talking about me, but I'm talking about Pastors Ron and Katie, Pastor Helen. You know, every one of us, we want to know you. And we want you to know that you're, if you come here and you fellowship here, you're part of our family. You're not just somebody come to church and another number. I had a friend of mine who went to a church in Atlanta. I forgot the name of the church. But there were so many people that went there that he said, you know, he said, Bishop said, it was nothing. I was a number. We never want people to feel like they're a number. You've been coming here long? Your second time? Well, that's good, ain't it? You got me today. Ain't that wonderful? Pastor Ron will be back next Sunday. He'll straighten up anything that I messed up, okay? All right? But Jeremiah, everybody say his name. Jeremiah. You feel welcome? Are you surprised I come back here? Tough to you? Yes, you are. How you doing, Amanda? It's good to see you. God bless you. There are great giftings and abilities in your life. I see it. I see it. I mean, God's going to take you great places. I don't know how young you are, but I'm going to tell you, God says, I got some great things for your future. I mean, some great things. Are you ready for it? Oh, just stay focused on the Lord and allow Him to work through and in your life, and you're going to see some wonderful things take place. And I'm telling you what, there's going to come a day financially in you that you can write the check you want to write. You watch it. You're going to write the check you want to write. Sir, I believe that. I believe that. I see. Just stay focused. Don't let nothing deter you left or right. And watch God bless you in abundant ways. Somebody says, why do we need money? Oh, y'all better hush your mouth. How many has a bill you have to pay? God wants to. Why? How come the world gets everything? We've allowed the world to control everything, to get a hold of everything. Worst thing the church ever did was back, and then suddenly the world started holding and controlling everything. The devil is a liar. Can I get an amen? The reason our nation is in the mess it is today is because a lot of people handle the money, cannot control it, do not have balance, do not have what they need to disperse it. Let godly men and women arise and godly men and women be there to handle these things. God wants you in every part of our system, right? He said, go into all the world. There's a difference between the world and the earth. The earth is the terra firma that we drove to church on today. But when he said go into all the world, he was talking from a word, it comes from a word cosmos, which means systems, orders, and arrangements of mankind and human beings. So when he said go into all the world, what is he saying? Go into all the cosmos, the systems, the orders, the arrangements of mankind and human beings. God wants people in every aspect of life. I'm telling you, just say, Lord, here am I. Use me. Where do you want me at? Amen? And we've got to have people there. I appreciate what Coach England is doing at CVCC. She has done phenomenal things there. God sent her there. I appreciate what Pastor Ron is doing there also at CVCC and what he does there. He's doing phenomenal things. You see what happened? They're allowing God to use them in their giftings. Pastor Katie, wonderful educator. We see her there and what she does there. It is incredible. Listen, I see so many. I heard several got advanced degrees. Who got advanced degrees? Coach England back here, we was there up in Western Carolina with her when she got a master's degree. Somebody else, April? What is it? Talk to me, girl. Talk to me now. Now, why should some ungodly, devilish person hold that position? Come on, y'all better talk to me now. I believe it's time for the church to arise and say, God, where do you want to set? Young people, you don't have to settle for the least when God can take you to the best. Tell us, Alexa, where are you at? Alexis. I got an Alexa in my home. Lord have mercy. A master. Give her a hand clap. Congratulations. Talents, giftings, and abilities, and whether it be a higher degree or whatever it is, God wants to use you. Don't ever say again, no, not me. Oh, not me. Yes, you. If not me, who? You know, I've had people tell me all my life what I could not do, but it didn't faze me a bit. I'd done it anyhow. And you can accomplish. You can. The Word of God says, I can do what? All things through Christ which strengthens me. Now, I don't know what they've got to play, but right now what I want to do, if I could get some help moving this, I got much more I could preach, much more I could talk about. But every one of us, God wants to use us in our giftings and abilities in serving. He wants to use us in a mighty way. We're going to open this altar up. I'm not going to pressure you to do it, but I really would like to, if we could, with Pastor Johnny and Pastor Helen and, Elders John and Francis and Brother Mike and Kathy, if they would join us, and Sister Dorothy, if you would join us too. What we want to do is we want to anoint you and pray for you today. Now, ushers, help me with this. Just place something back there, if you would, Brother Jody or Sister Tony. You that are here today, and first of all, I want to pray for Mama. Bring me that oil back here. I'm so thankful today that I'm not on, I'm on God's schedule, nothing else. All right, just put some in my hand. Mama, I want to pray for you, okay? I want to pray for you. Pastor Helen, lay your hands on these legs. Father, in the name of Jesus right now, Lord, this woman has served her family, has served the house of God. And Lord, I pray for her right now in the name that's above every name, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Minister healing right now. Minister healing in her body, Jesus. Oh God, I thank you for it today. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I've got to pray for a couple people back here. I'm going to pray for you, Sister Willie Ann. You can just stay there if you want to. Where's that oil? In the name of Jesus. In the name, will you worship the Lord with us? Father, I just anoint this precious woman of God. She's served you for years and years. She's been faithful to the things of God. Lord, there are great giftings and talents, so that's still in her.
I pray for this physical body. Lord, let there be healing in this body. Touch her, God. Oh, in the name of Jesus. Lift her today. Oh, God, you're not through with her yet either. There are great things that you want to do in and through her life. I thank you for it. Oh, God, I just praise you right now. Yes, God. Oh, somebody give God praise today, would you? Would you give him praise? Oh, would you give him praise? Lord, I just thank you right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I anoint Raynell right now. I pray, God, for every aspect of these joints. I pray, God, for this knee. I pray for her back. God, every part of it, you're a healing Jesus. Oh, mighty God, right now. Touch her right now, God. Thank you for it. Thank you, God. You praise him, honey. You praise him. Give me some oil. Give me some oil. Ain't through yet. Ain't through yet. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Come here. Father, I just pray right now for Sister Willie. And I pray, God, for this back. I pray for every element of her body. I impart healing. You're a healing Jesus. And by the stripes of the Lord Jesus Christ, she is healed. And she's whole today. Thank you, mighty God. Oh, we just praise you. We just praise you. We praise you. Thank you, God. 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 God, restore complete health in these knees right now. Can I touch your knees in the name of Jesus right now? In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, minister healing, God. Minister healing, Jesus. Thank you, God, right now. Oh, by the stripes of Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you. Come on, let's praise God. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Give him a praise. Father, I just anoint Gwendolyn right now. And first of all, we send your word to Lewis. We send your word. Oh, God, you said in the Old Testament, you sent your word and healed them and delivered them from any destruction. Send your word to Lewis. We curse every element that's come against his body. Oh, God, bring healing. And we pray for Gwendolyn now also. God, bring healing in this body. In Jesus' name, complete healing, that she will stand and declare, this is the Lord's doings. God, we thank you. 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 Lay your hands on Sister Lisa back there. Now, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we send your word to, oh, Brother Alex. Oh, God, you're a mighty God. And, Lord, I believe he still has dreams and visions in his heart and in his mind. Send your word to him today. Heal him, God. Oh, God, we thank you. You're the great physician. Write the prescription for what Alex needs. And we pray for Lisa today. Strengthen this precious woman of God. Oh, touch her body. Strengthen her, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Oh, let's praise God. Let's praise him. You praise him. Let's praise him. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. I want you to anoint Sister Marvel there for me. It's not by accident you're here at church today. Listen, this is nothing but the Lord that you're here. God told me to tell you this. He's not through with you yet. Quit hiding what's in you, girl. God wants to use you in a mighty way. And I'm going to pray for your body, that God is going to minister healing to this body. And there are things that you still want to accomplish, still want to do and achieve. God's not through with you yet. Oh, hear that today. Father, I lay my hands on this girl right now. I thank you for Marva today. Almighty God. Almighty God, there's giftings, talents, abilities that's deep inside of her. Bring them out, Lord. Bring them out today. Oh, God, and touch this body. I come against every element that's come against her body physically. By the stripes of the Lord Jesus Christ, she is healed. Oh, you praise him, honey. You praise him. You praise him. You praise him. Yes, God. Yes, God. Oh, mighty God. Mighty God. Oh, praise God, praise God, praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Where is she at? Where is she at? See, the Lord just speaks to me. He speaks to me about certain people. Can I pray with you? I want to pray with you. You know what? I feel your pain. I feel your hurt. I don't know what all it's about or what it is, but I can just feel you reaching out. And I've seen such a glow about you today. The presence of the Lord is in your life. Oh, my word. God's not through with you yet. He's got some great things he's going to use you in. And there are wonderful giftings, talents, and abilities that's hid in there. And you say, well, God, me? Yes. Yes, you. I don't even know what you do. Don't even know your name. But that's all right. He does. Now, Father, today I impart to this young lady, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, I thank you right now. Minister to her. I pray for her today. And I thank you, God, for complete healing emotionally, peace in these emotions, rest in this spirit. Lift her in every way, God. When she walks out of this church today, she'll know that you've touched her. Thank you, God. You praise him, honey. You just praise him. You praise him, okay? There's change. I've seen change happening for you. Change happening for you. Oh, praise God, praise God. Praise God, praise God. Amen. Oh, clap your hands like you mean it, folks. Come on. Listen, what I want to do today, let me take Carlos, stand up for me back there. I'm telling you, I'm going to say this to you by the Holy Ghost. There is greatness in you. Greatness. Where you're at now is not where God's going to take you. There's greatness. I heard Tyler Perry. Anybody heard of Tyler Perry? I heard him speak, and he had one of the most outstanding things he said. He said as he began to go up, he said there were people that suddenly fell off from his life. And he said the problem was they was just like booster rockets. He said you have booster rockets, it takes a rocket up into space. He said, but at a certain altitude, the boosters fall off because they've served their purpose. But the boosters cannot go where the main rocket's going. Carlos, you're a rocket. And these boosters trying to hang on to you, they cannot go where you're going. That's the reason sometimes you wonder, why did that person... Why'd they kind of back off from? Why'd that It's because, my God, you're a rocket, man. You're going up there. You're going up. I'm not talking about the heaven now. I'm talking about places God's going to take you that the boosters cannot go. And then you'll come back around the boosters, and the boosters will say, oh, my God, we never believed that God could do this through you. Can I get an amen from somebody? Listen, you cannot. There's times in our lives that the boosters have to fall off. Come on. How many of you have been pulled down and tugged down by the boosters that's trying to hang on to you, that's sucking, oh, y'all ain't listening to me, that's sucking the very life out of you? Let the boosters go. Come on, let's be like rockets. Let's go up where God wants us to be. Amen. There's an old song they used to sing, Lord, lift me up where I belong. Oh, my God, I hope y'all feel what I'm feeling today. I'm getting older, but I ain't lost a lot, I'll tell you right now. I want everyone today, I don't know what they want to play, just something that's exciting and wonderful and great. Every one of you that wants me to lay hands on you today, and Pastor Helen and others that's with us, Brother Mike, Sister Kathy, y'all come down, just stand with us. Appreciate it. Every one of you that wants prayer, that wants us to lay hands on you and stir up the gift that is in your life. I don't know what all those gifts are. I just want to lay hands on you, Pastor Helen or Brother Johnny. Pastor Johnny will anoint you. And then I want you to come. Just move that out the way. And if the folks here would just kind of gather around us. And everybody else, if you give us just a few minutes, we'll get through this. We'll get through this. In the name of Jesus, Lord, this precious sister today, we lay our hands upon her. Laying their hands upon. We thank you for an impartation. Oh, we stir up the gift, God. Jesus. Lord, be stirred up. It's going to be stirred up. It's going to be stirred up. Oh, my God, girl, there's gifts. There's gifts in there. And God's going to start bringing them out. He's going to bring them out. Listen, let me tell you something. There's boots falling off you today. You're a rocket, girl. Oh, you're a rocket. Stand up, God. Oh, stand up, Lord, the gifts that's in her. In Jesus' name. Oh, praise him. money. Give me some skin. You praise him. You praise him. Oh, there's great gifts and abilities. Oh, the boosters. Did that resonate with you? The boosters got to fall off. Come on, the boosters fall off. It's amazing. I told that to Carlos for the boosters fall off. Oh, God, thank you for Tyra. Jesus, Jesus. Oh, God, there are great places you're taking. Oh, God, let her be free from the boosters because she's a rocket that's going to soar for your glory. In Jesus' name, stir it up, Lord. Stir that gift, God. Amen, amen. Man, praise God, praise God, praise God. Thank you for the giftings and the abilities that's in this young lady. Lord, she's already went great places, but she's going to do even greater. Stir up the gift that is in her in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Sister Tisha, come down, just stand with us. Just stand with us. I want what you got to be imparted into these lives. Almighty God. Almighty God. This message was right for you today, wasn't it? Right there. Listen, don't ever say, not me. Not me. No, 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 no. Point that you say, hey, I know what God's put in me. I know the education I have and all that God's given me. I won't use me. That's all you got to do. Boosters are falling off. That's the reason they can't stay. It's all, let them go, girl, because go where God wants you to go. The gift that's in April. Oh, mighty gifts in her. Stir up, Lord, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus, in Jesus' name. Come here, son, let me tell you, stir it. There's something in you, there's something in you deep God wants to bring out of you. Some of these tore you, pour to your life, battling you do that. And sometimes the boosters have to fuck it. God to take you places. Now, Lord, I pray for James today, and in the name of Jesus, I impart into him, and I stir up the gift of God that is in his life, Lord. Oh, bring it out of him, God. Bring it out of him in Jesus' name. And I hear the Lord saying, think it not strange that he won't wake you up in the midnight hour, early in the morning, to fall on your knees and begin to call on his name. And as he does these things, as God begins to deal with you, receive what he's doing. Thank you, God. Oh, let's praise him. Let's praise him. Let's praise him. Oh, in Jesus' name, I thank you for Michaela. Look at me. There are great giftings and abilities in you. There absolutely is. Don't be afraid to let them be afraid for God to use you. It's all right, okay? It's all right. Don't let them in there. The gift. Hand on you today. I'm just saying, God, stir up that gift. Are you ready for that? Stir up that gift. Father, I pray for Taylor right now, and I pray in the name of Jesus, stir up the gift, Lord, that's in her. She's got great giftings and abilities and talents. Stir them up, God. And Lord, she... use her in a special way in Jesus' name. Praise God. Praise God. Bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Great giftings, great talents, great abilities. Amen. You know what? You're going to get a double portion. You're going to get the portion your father has and your mama has. And I'm telling you, girl, that's pretty powerful, ain't it? You ain't no booster rocket. You're a rocket that's going to take high where the can't go. You're going to reach an altitude. Are you ready for that? Are you in school anywhere or anything? Where are you? You're A&T. All right. Thank you. Great school. Great school. Let me tell you something. A&T can be like a booster that can help take you to that place you want to go. You ready for this? This message was for you today. There's great giftings, talents, and ability. Don't say it's somebody else. No, no, no. It's you. It's absolutely you. Father, I pray for this precious lady today. And God, I thank you for using her in a mighty way. Favored in new doors, new avenues, and new. I thank you for it, Jesus. Thank you, God. You praise him, honey. You praise him, okay? You praise him. You praise him. Lord, I thank you for Nicole today. God, I thank you for just up the gift of God in her. She has a heart for you. I know that. Minister to her in every way. And Lord, all this that's been coming at her, Jesus, in every way, oh God, just free her mind. Bring her deep peace, a peace that's beyond anything that she's ever known before. And a spirit of rest, God. Thank you for stirring the gift up, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You've already seen favor. You've already seen God open great doors that you never thought possible. But can I tell you something? That's just a little bit. That's just a down payment of what He wants to do for you. Are you ready? Or you just got to say, Lord, I'm available. Where am I wanted? Where am I needed? Where do you use me? And listen, don't wait until that comes to be ready, but be ready before it comes. So when it happens, bam! Can I say bam? Yes, I can. You're ready to go. Now, Lord, I for my precious, this precious little I seen when she was born into this earth. Oh, mighty God, use her in a mighty way. I stir up the gift that's in her today. Jesus, I thank you. Oh, God, give her wisdom beyond her years. Give her knowledge. Give her revelation knowledge. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Praise God. And remember me. Listen. Remember me when you come into your kingdom. You hear me? All right. All right. Bless your daughter. I've seen this. Listen. I've seen this. I want to tell you. You talk about a testimony in this church. I've seen this daughter here when she come back to take care of her mother, Betty, years and years ago. When she come back to take care of her mother, Betty. Believe this or not, she was down here at Newton High School just volunteering. Volunteering, using her gift to those down there and to those young ladies playing basketball. And I think your Shanice, think about that. And all she'd just been faithful, just being where God wanted her. God honored and blessed her so much. The job at CVC come open. And since that time till now, not only does she have a master's degree, but this girl's in four Hall of Fames. She's one of the few players in Newton Conover history that ever had jersey retired. It's still down there, right? Ever had a jersey retired from a female basketball player. Only that, not only in four Hall of Fames, that'd be enough, wouldn't it? Her jersey retired. Then she went down to UNC South Carolina at Aiken, and her jersey retired down there. And they voted her one of the greatest athletes in the last 100 years in the state of North Carolina. Somebody ought to give God some praise. She had a praying mama. She had a praying grandma. Let me tell you, don't let nobody tell you, well, if you have the Lord, you know you can't do that. Let me tell you, you can have do that. You know what I preached Friday at the memorial service? I talked about being a living memorial before God. And I talked about a police officer that lived 2,000 years ago. His name was Cornelius of Caesarea. He was a police officer. Now think about that. I believe I had a few ears listening. I really do. But building a living memorial before God. And I've worked with a lot of men and women in law enforcement, and many of them, you know what they are? They're a living memorial before God. And let me tell you something. God's done all that for you. See, some people, if God done all that, they say, okay, thank you, Lord, I'm ready to go. I don't think she's there yet, because I believe this is the tip of the iceberg where God wants to take her. Honestly, you believe that? Daughter, I believe that. This is the tip of the iceberg. I've told you that before. Great is ahead. Pastor Helen, come over. Elders, Brother Mike says, okay, y'all, Father, right now, I thank you. Stir up the gift, Lord. There are greater places. And Lord, there are even booster rockets that's going to fall off. But she's a rocket that's going to go to another altitude. Oh God, stir the gift up. That new gift, that fresh gift, that new place you want her. Oh mighty God, and right now, just give her peace, God. Oh Lord, oh God, let the Holy Ghost just flow all through her right now, Lord. I praise you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Stay up here with us. Stay up here with us. Stay up here with us. Have you dedicated this child to the Lord yet? Well, when he's back, you get him to dedicate this child. It's really important that this child is dedicated unto the Lord. I'm going to lay my hands on her, but I want Pastor Ron and Pastor Kate to do the dedication. Now, Father, today I lay my hands on this child, and Lord, even official dedication, I pray a hedge of protection around her. I plead the blood of Jesus over her. And I pray also for Kelly. God, I plead the blood of Jesus over her. Stir up the gift, Lord, that's in her. Minister to her, God. Oh, in every way, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Oh, praise God, praise God. I believe the Lord's in this place today. Young man, stay focused, stay determined. What grade you are in school?
Seventh.
You're in what?
Seventh.
Let me tell you, stay focused. Mama, daddy, pour into him. Pour into him, because you know what? The Lord wants to do great things. I know he's done great things through your brother, but you know what? You also, God wants to do great things for you, because you're two individuals. You have two different giftings and talents and abilities. Come a little closer to me. I won't bite, I promise, all right? Now, Lord, I just pray for this young man today. I thank you for ministering to him. Just touch him. Impart to him. Strap the gift in him, God. Oh, Lord, great things are coming. Great things are happening. Pray a hedge of protection around him. Plead the blood of Jesus over him. Amen. Amen. Give me some skin, man. Give me some skin. That's the Holy Ghost touching you, son. What's your name?
Lundy.
What is it?
Lundy.
Come a little closer.
Lundy.
Lundy's pleasure to meet you today. Thank you for coming to church today and being here. I want to pray for you, okay? You ever had a minister lay hands on you before? Okay, well, you're used to it then, ain't you? But every time I lay hands on somebody, there's an impartation that takes place. I personally believe that. Lord, I pray for London. There's giftings and talents and abilities in this young man. Pray a hedge of protection around him. Plead the blood of Jesus over him. He's a good young man. He has a heart for you. I plead the blood over him and strap the gift that's in him. Touch him today. In Jesus' name, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. See this man right here? Listen to him. He's a great man. He can give you, all these men in here can give you wonderful guidance and instruction. How old are you?
13.
You need it at that age, okay? And they will guide you and direct you. God bless you. God bless you. Noel, Noel, Noel. Noel, I love this guy. I remember when he was born. My God, how old are you? Sometimes I feel young, sometimes not so young. I pray for Noel. And God, I pray you will just stir up that's in him. Touch him, minister to him and through him. Oh, young man, great things are coming for him and to him. Let the boosters fall away from his life. Jesus, I thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. I love you. Give me a hug. Bless you, young man. What's your name?
Jay.
Jay, come a little closer, Jay. I want to pray for you. 16. How old are you?
12.
Well, I thought you was big. You know, you're big for your age. You get that a lot? All right. It's all right. Hey, man. By the time you get to high school, you're going to be a great football player or basketball player. Or you don't even have to play at all. You're going to just focus on your academics totally. But I don't know what you want to do in your life. But let me tell you, be around godly men that can guide you with wisdom, okay? And I want to pray for you today, because I feel inside your heart there's a lot of searching going on. But you know what? The Lord's going to guide you. Let him guide you. Remember when I talked about the boosters falling off? Bad fall off. You don't need them. That's just like, let me show you, for instance, if somebody's never made $1 million, how can they tell you how to make it? I mean, they've lost money and lost money and lost money. Listen, get away from them people. And I ain't trying to be funny, but I've made $1 million. Now, it took me a lifetime to get there. But I have made it. So don't listen to somebody that's not successful. Listen to somebody that's successful. Come on, talk to me, people.
I mean, you get around these people that's not successful and burn out and everything in between and losing everything. What they going to tell you? That's like we used to have some kind of marriage counseling in our area here that had been divorced, what is it, 3 times or 4 times? And I told people, don't go to that man. Only thing he can show you what to do is how to get a divorce. Oh, my word. His license ought to be pulled from him. Some 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years. Go to somebody like that. They can tell you how to stay married. Talk to me, people. Can I pray with you? I'm a different preacher, ain't I? I thought you'd say that. Most people say that. Father, I thank you for this precious young man. He's very reverent to you. He's sensitive to your spirit. Lord, a lot of questions stirring in his heart and mind. Now, God, guide him and direct him. Stir up the gift in him. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to tell you something. Look at me. If you will stay focused, determined, not let nothing move you to the right or the left, let the boosters fall away because you're a rocket, you'll soar. You hear me? And you're going to be great one day. Can I tell you that? You are going to be, there's greatness built in you. I see it. I can see you. Hopefully, I'll still be on this planet Earth, but I can see you some years from now, and God will be opening doors. And you say, I remember that preacher on that Sunday that told me that. I remember that. All right? Come on, talk to him. Give me some skin. All right. All right. Praise God. You know, when I looked at this young man, we come into my class, he's taking my some biblical principles class. When he came into my class, I thought, there's something special about that young man. Not just because your mama goes here. That's pretty good. Come here. I love you, man. I love you. I just see God using you. I really do. I see God using you. And Father, the boosters are falling off. And Lord, this man's a rocket that's going to soar into altitude that even some of his family's never reached before. Lord, your favor's upon him, and I thank you today in Jesus' name. Bless you, my friend. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. This woman of God here has touched so many lives and ministered to so many people. Oh, God, you're not through with Mamie yet. I pray for her today. I pray clarity. I pray, God, that you're going to minister just complete healing to her body. Oh, Jesus, touch her right now. Stop.